Hello, my dear friend, you are welcome to my channel. In this video, I intend to explain in detail and also to practically show you how to interlock two contactors electrically. Okay, so what is contactor interlocking and why do we need it? Alright, so when two contactors are used in an electrical circuit and we need only one of the two contactors to turn on at a time, then we need the interlocking system. This is an electrical interlocking of two contactors that are not supposed to close at the same time. So if this contactor is engaged, there is no way the other one should start if someone mistakenly presses its start button, because we don't want these contactors to close at the same time. So you see that when this one is closed, this one is open. Even if I try to manually close this contactor, it will close all right, but the arrangement is such that because we don't want the two contactors to close at the same time, before this one closes, this one must open. All right, so let's look at what will happen. And before it closes, this one has to go off. Anytime one is on, one will be off. And so here, if I press the start for the lamp, it will not work because this contactor cannot close when this one is working. And if I try to manually close it, before it closes, this one has to go up like this. All right, so it's either you use mechanical interlock or electrical interlock. For a better understanding of the whole system, you need to carefully follow the step-by-step practical wiring of the circuit. So this interlocking system can be wired by either using two start buttons for the different loads, or by using one start button and then a timer, as in the case of star delta wiring. Okay, so in order to make the whole thing simple and clear, I would like to explain certain parts of the wiring with a diagram so that it will make it simple for understanding. Then I will continue with the practical. So I'll represent the contacts on the contactor by 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then the contactors are two, so another one will be here. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So actually, there is a link. So here, 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 here. So this is just to show that these are the terminals of the contactor. So here will be L1, here will be L2, here will be L3, and then here will be terminal 13, NO, normally opened. Then at the output, we have T1, T2, T3, and then 14, normally opened contacts. And the same thing happens here. So here, L1, L2, L3, 13. 14, T3, T2, and then T1. This represents the contactor terminals. L1, T1, L1, T1, and so on. The contactor has a coil that must also be energized at A1 and then A2. So that coil, I'll represent the coil like this. This is the coil with terminals A1 and then A2. So this coil is on this contactor. Then here, there is a coil also here. This one also has A1 and then A2. All right. Then, in this arrangement, this pair of contacts is very, very important. It's actually this pair of contacts that can help us to do what we are going to do. And so, these are two pairs of normally closed contacts. And all is going to be attached to a contactor. So anytime this main contacts close, these contacts will open. All right, we use one on each of the contactors. And I'm going to represent those terminals as this, and this, this, and this. And here also this, and this, this, and this. But these ones, they are normally closed. Like this. Then the next thing that we will be using is the start push button. All right, so basically, this is how the stop push button looks like. This one has just two terminals, labeled terminal 1 and terminal 2. But the one I'll be using has three terminals. But one thing you must know is that we need only two contacts to wire the stop push button. And those two contacts must be normally closed. Here, this contact must be continuous to this one, like this. So here, among these three connections, we need the normally closed connection to do our wiring. All right, so here, I'm looking for the normally closed contact. So here, this is normally opened, and then here. Okay, so we are using this contact and this one. Then in the start, it's also the same thing. It's only the color that differs. So here, two pairs of these terminals are open and then two are closed. But in the start push button wiring, we need two normally opened contacts. So we can use the continuity tester to check which of these two are normally open. So this and this are normally closed. This and this are normally open. So we are using this and this in the wiring. Okay. We also have a breaker. And then the breaker also has an input like this. And then an output terminal like this. From the breaker, it needs to go to the stop push button. And then the stop push button is normally closed like this. So when you push it, it opens. Then we go to the start push button for lamp 1, and the start push button is normally opened like this. So you push and it closes. But the start push buttons are 2. So we have another one here like this. Open. You press and it closes. So here we have our contactor with the normally closed auxiliary contact. Coil is intact. We have our switch. We have stop button, start button 1, and then start button 2. All right, so these are the things that we need to learn and understand how to wire the electrical interlocking system for two contactors. All right, so the next thing is that I'm going to take my time to show in the drawing how all these components will be connected with electrical cables so that we can get our interlocking system. All right, so first of all, we need a live connection first into the switch, MCB. Then this is stop, this is start. So we can name this one start 1, and this is start 2. We have this contactor, and then we have this contactor. Let's name this contactor 1, and then this contactor 2. Okay. All right. I think it's clear enough. All right. So here we need live and neutral supply. Neutral. And then live. Okay. We need live and neutral to power the control circuit. So here we take live from here. And then into the switch like this. Then from the switch, we connect to one terminal of the start push button. All right, so I have to say that these terminals are labeled, but connection from the switch to the stop button could come to either terminal 1 or terminal 2, depending on how you position the switch. If you position it this way, then it means this wire will connect to terminal 2. But if you position it this way, then it means this wire will connect to terminal 1. And so that is why I did not bother labeling the terminals. Okay. The important thing is that you have to know where the cables that are coming here will connect from and then where they will connect to. Okay. So here we have this one in. Then from here, we connect it to one terminal of the first start push button. Then here, we take a look from either this terminal on the stop button or this terminal on the start button. We can take power from any of these points. But then, let's take it from here, and then we loop it to one terminal on the other start push button, like this. So from here to here, like this. Okay. Now, we have two terminals on our start push buttons connected, and then we have the other sides open. All right, so at this point, you must observe carefully. The next thing I'm going to do is, I'm going to take a connection from this start button to this normally closed contact on contactor one. Actually, this connection I'm going to do, it could be to one pair of the normally closed contact on contactor two or contactor one. And then I will loop to the other normally closed contact. This is how it is done. So from this terminal on the start push button, I'll go straight to the normally closed contact on contactor one. But the normally closed contacts there are two. So I'm using one pair for this. The second pair also has a work to do. All right. So from this side of the start push button to one of the normally closed contacts on contactor one, then I'll loop from here to the other normally closed contact like this. All right. So let's finish up quickly with the practical. I have my two contactors, and then the normally closed auxiliary contacts, one here, and then the second one here. Then I have the stop push button, and then start push button one, and then start push button two. Okay. All right. So let's begin. First of all, I need a live connection to the single pole breaker that controls power to the control circuit. Then from the output of the breaker to one terminal of the stop push button. So from the other side of the stop push button, we need two connections. One will go to one terminal of the first start button, and then the other one will go to one terminal of the second start push button. One will come here. We also need one connection from here again to the normally closed contact. So from here. So now this other cable from the start push button will also connect to this second start push button. All right, so to prevent any confusion, I'll do the arrangement just as I did it in the drawing. So in the drawing, we had the stop push button, then we had a start one push button, and then a start two push button. Then the contactor closest to the breaker is named contactor one, and then the one further from the breaker is named contactor two. So in this arrangement, I'm going to maintain the same sequence. So this is the breaker, this is the stop push button, this is start one, this is start two, this is contactor one, this is contactor two. All right, so just as it was shown in the drawing, from this terminal, it comes to the normally closed contact. And then when it comes to the normally closed contact, we take a loop from there to the next auxiliary contact. So we take a loop from here to here. Okay. All right. So from the first start push button, where we had the connection from the stop push button, we took a loop from there to the normally closed contact. Then we took a loop from there to the other normally closed contact. Then the next thing we're going to do is that we take a connection from this output here, and then we connect it to terminal 13 on the second contactor. Terminal 13 on the second contactor. Then from the output here also, take a connection to terminal 13 on the first contactor, like this. Then we are left with one pair each on the auxiliary contacts. So now, this start button is supposed to energize this coil. And so we are going to take a connection from the second terminal on this start button to this coil. But before it comes to connect to this coil, it has to pass through the normally closed contact on the second contactor. So we take a connection from here. And then it has to pass through this normally closed contact here. From the other side of the normally closed here, so from here,
Then we take it to A2 of the coil of contactor 1. So here we connect this here. And then we take a loop to terminal 14 on the same contactor. Terminal 14 here on the same contactor. And then here, we are left with the connection from the other terminal of the second start button to energize the coil of contactor 2. Okay, so we take that from here. And just as we did for the start 1 push button, this one has to pass through the normally closed contact on contactor 1 before it connects to terminal A2 on the second contactor. So from here, then we take it to terminal A2. Actually, we could have connected it to terminal A1, but because this red was connected to terminal A2, I just want to connect that one also here so that we'll have all the reds at terminal A2 and all the blacks at terminal A1. And again, just as we did for the first contactor, we are taking a loop from this terminal A2 to terminal 14 on the same contactor. So we take a loop from here. We take a loop from here to terminal 14. Okay. Wiring is done. This circuit is actually powered by 230 volts. And so you make sure that all bare terminals are properly insulated before you try testing. All right, so now work is done. It's left with my neutral connections to A1 here and then A1 here. Okay, this main neutral, and then I'll take a loop to the other coil. Then I take a loop to the other coil like this. Okay, and so soon that brings us to the end of our wiring. It looks a bit complex at the end, but if you carefully follow from the beginning, you would realize that it is quite simple to do. These two start buttons will help me to energize each of these coils at a time. So in the wiring, this start button is supposed to activate this contactor. And then this start button is supposed to activate this contactor. All right, and the purpose of this wiring is to ensure that these two contactors do not close at the same time. And so when this one is on, this one cannot come on. Even if you try pressing it mechanically, the one that is on should go off before that one will work. So let's go. First contactor. First contactor is activated. And so this second one will not work. Okay. So let's turn it off, and then let's activate the second contactor. So here, second contactor is activated, and no matter how you press this first one, it will not work. Okay, let's go off. Now, let's switch first contactor on. Let's also try to manually close this second contactor, and let's see what happens. So here, I want to mechanically force and close this contactor, and this is what you will see. So this system will not permit both contactors to close at the same time. So now this one is on, and so if I press here, this one will not work. If I try to press it mechanically, this one has to go off before this one goes. So here to not work. Okay, so off, on, it doesn't work. If I try to close it, this one will go off. On, if I press this one, it will not work. If I try to manually close it, the other one will switch off. All right, so that brings us to the end of how to interlock two contactors. My dear friend, if you have learned something from this video, please don't hesitate to like, share with others to also benefit, and please don't forget to subscribe if you have not yet subscribed. There are a lot of videos like this that will be coming your way. Thank you very much and stay connected.